Welcome to today's edition.
Come in, everybody, to the Clay Travis and Buck Sexton Show. I'm coming to you live from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Clay Travis, my main man, is in Nashville, Tennessee. So we'll be bringing you all of the latest. Thanks for being here with us.
Hello, everyone. I'm Natalie Gadilla. I'm a Caucasian woman with long blonde hair, and I go by she, her. I'm a product marketing lead here at Microsoft and co-host of the podcast Security Unlocked with this guy.
Yes, that would be me. Hello, everyone. I'm Nick Fillingham. I'm a Caucasian man with glasses and a beard. I go by he, him, and I'm a security evangelist here at Microsoft.
No, hold on. So the explanation that I saw online for this, I'm not even sure about, is the visually impaired thing. I wanted to play that because they do the whole he, him, she, her, as if,
yes,
believe it or not, Clay, we knew from hearing, we knew from their voices. I know this is a crazy idea. You can actually tell the difference between male and female voice 99 times out of 100. I know this is a shock to libs. But even with the visually impaired thing, why would they feel discluded? I'm not sure that really, it seems strange to me. I've never heard that before.
Well, this also just further ties in with your identity has become a modern form of royalty. Back in the day, and I think sometimes maybe people still introduce themselves, but somebody would come out and say, as the, you know, third Earl Rockingham, fourth Viscount of the third kingdom, I believe. And what gave legitimacy to your belief system was the title that you preceded the I believe with. Pay attention on television how often you hear someone say, as a gay, Hispanic, trans man, I believe. Well, why should I care? I mean, in terms of your opinion, I care about what you believe, but why should I care about the preface of your identity? Your identity should not give legitimacy to the arguments that you make. We have gone back in time in the same way that aristocracy used to use their bloodline as a legitimate basis for their opinions, which is what we revolted against in the United States. People now use their identities, which they were given at birth. It's not like you have ended up choosing to be, you know, black or white or Asian or Hispanic. You're born that way.
John, thanks for joining us. You say you know that this is nonsense. Tell us why.
Not only is it nonsense, Buck, by the way, you guys have big shoes to fill and you're doing an excellent job. I am legally blind and I am visually impaired. I have Stargardt's disease. I've had it since birth. And these people are offending me. They're not going to turn me into a victim and use me and my disability for an excuse for their weird, exotic, bizarre behavior, man.
So, John, when they say they're describing what people look like and their ethnicity to help visually impaired people, as a visually impaired individual, you're telling us that's bull crap.
It's nonsensical. It doesn't make a difference in the world. If you can't see, you just can't see. I don't need you people to explain to me how you look. They're just trying to victimize us like they do with everybody and anything, man.
John,
I'm so sick of it.
John, God bless. Thanks for calling in and telling us, you know, dropping some truth bombs here on the libs and helping us out with it. We appreciate it, man. Thank you so much. And thank you for listening.